not safe. This is not the safest idea. Squat of the day, and I'm bleeding. I don't know if you can see that all across my back as well, but I've got some little numbness going on all through here. It feels kind of funny, enough to take your mind off everything. The most difficult part of the lift is the unrack and getting stable. I can make up an excuse and say it's because something with my back is off, or my leg feels funny, or I don't really know. This is the most weight I've had on a squat bar in a long time that wasn't bands or chains. So it's gonna require a different kind of balance anyway, because the bands and chains aren't kind of balancing out the bar and anchoring it to the ground or the rack or whatever. But, and coming off this box with this drop pad on here, it's different than straight foam, because the pleather on the outside holds air inside. So the longer, when I sit on it, I can feel air coming out of the zipper here on my thigh. So the longer that I sit on the box, like the deeper it gets. And I can feel myself when I'm down there. I have nothing to drive off of. So if you've ever done a box squat before, you get to the box and you have something you can drive off of. You know, your point of contact goes from just being your feet on the floor to feet on the floor and butt on the box. And you can use that kind of triangle position, you know, a tripod push off of three objects, a foot, and your butt on the box. With this, It's like a phantom pressure. It's really like doing just a straight squat, but it's kind of messing with my mind a little bit, because I'm continually sinking when I sit, and then I'm sinking, and then I'm driving up. There's no stop position. Maybe that's the best way to explain it. On a box squat, there's a stop position. On this, there is no stop. It's a continual sink, a slow continual sink. And I'm having to drive back up off of that sink. So it's strange. Is it effective? I don't know. Probably not. This will probably be the last time I do this for about a year. But I haven't done it in a long time, so it was time to do it. But anyway, this is 555, 566. So, you know, the weight's not hard. I came up fast. It's just a balance and everything else feels off. And is it worth taking a risk just to do six plates? Nah, it's not. I really wanted six plates. I know I can do six plates, but is it worth the risk of anything going wrong? It's not. So let's move on to the next exercise, guys.